Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are talking about ROS2, which is Robot Operating System. I will go over what is ROS, its importance in robotics, and how to install ROS2. Here are all the timings and I'll also include it in the description below. So without further ado, let's get into it. What's ROS, or Robot Operating System? As their website says, Robot Operating System is a set of software libraries and tools for building robot applications. It is the software in middle that lets you work with different robots, different parts of robots, and different libraries. By different robots, I mean ROS can work with any robotic hardware, and you can have a combinations of different robots communicating with one another using ROS. At the same time, within each of your robots, you can use ROS to communicate with different sensors. Plus, ROS makes it super easy to use existing libraries and pieces of code written by different people or organizations, making ROS an abstract layer that can work on anything. And it's all open source. Another way to think of ROS is that it's a communication bridge, making it easy to transfer messages from one robot or sensor to another. And that should tell you its importance in robotics. ROS helps enable robotics and make it easier for you to collaborate. ROS is not robotics. ROS is what enables robotics to easily bring different pieces together. ROS was started in 2007, and over the years they've had multiple releases. And then in 2015, they started working on ROS2 with their first release, Ardent Apollon, in 2017. The latest ROS2 version being Foxy, released in 2020. They still do new releases for ROS1. And here's a fun fact. All the releases are named after different turtle species, going alphabetically. With that, let's get into how to install ROS2. We will go with the latest ROS2 release, which is Foxy. An important thing to note is the system requirements. ROS2 Foxy requires Ubuntu 20. I've seen a lot of people trying to install this on Ubuntu 18 and get a package not found error. Make sure to check which OS is supported for each release before installing it. I have Ubuntu 20 here and I'm going to use the Debian package method to install ROS2. We will follow the instructions from ROS2 wiki page, and I'll also show you some tricks to make it easier to install and use ROS2. Let's start with a new terminal. I'm using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl, Alt, and T, and I'm making it larger using Ctrl, Shift, and Plus. The first step in installing ROS2 is setting up locale. You can type locale to check if it's already installed and set to UTF-8. In case you don't have it, here's what you do next. We'll update the system with sudo apt update and then install locale with sudo apt install locale. Next, we'll set some configurations. I will copy paste the command one by one. Remember, paste in the terminal window is Ctrl, Shift, and V, and not Ctrl and V. I'm also using the keyboard shortcut Shift and Tab to switch between terminal and Google Chrome. Lastly, type in locale again to check the settings. The next step in installing ROS2 is setting up sources. Again, I'm doing copy paste. Now, if you run into error git command not found, it means you don't have git. Simply use sudo apt-get install git to install git and continue forward with installing ROS2. The next step is installing the ROS2 package. Before we do that, we will do a quick update. And with that, we will install the ROS2 package. Because I'm going with ROS2 Foxy, I'm installing the ROS Foxy desktop version. Again, if you get the error of missing package, make sure you are meeting the system requirements, which is Ubuntu 20 for ROS2 Foxy. Now, this is a big package and it took me about 10 minutes to download it. I'm speeding up the video for now. With that, ROS2 is now installed, and to use it, you need to set up your environment. Setting up the environment means telling your computer where the ROS2 package is installed, and you can do this by sourcing the setup file which has all the paths. To illustrate this point, let's use the command print environment. This will give you a list of environment variables which are essentially paths to different softwares and applications downloaded on your computer. We're going to use grep to narrow down our options to ROS. And as you can see, we have nothing. Now let's source the environment variable. Let's check the environment variables again using print environment. As you can see, we now have ROS2 in our environment. One problem with this method is you will have to do it over and over again every time you have a new terminal. To illustrate this, let me create a new terminal using keyboard shortcut Ctrl, Shift and T. Using print environment, you can see we no longer have ROS2 environment variables. You can source the environment variables, but having to do it again and again is cumbersome. So here's a quick tip. We will add our source command to bashrc. Bashrc is a shell script that runs when you start a new terminal, which is a new session. To add our source command to bashrc, we will use echo. Now our ROS2 environment variables will be sourced for every new terminal we open. Again, every new terminal. So if you go to the old terminal, it won't work. But if you open a new terminal, it will. Let's continue with our ROS2 installation. Let's install Python 3 pip and then use pip 3 to install arc complete. To check that ROS2 works, let's run a small example. Remember, ROS2 is like a communication bridge. So in one terminal, we will run a script to send messages, which is called a publisher. And in another terminal, we will run a script to listen to these messages, which is called a subscriber. Let's start with our publisher. Again, we don't have to source the path, we just run the publisher using ROS run. Make a note of the fact that this is a C++ file. As you can see, this terminal is now publishing the message Hello World. Let's open another terminal using keyboard shortcut Ctrl, Shift and T. Here we will run our subscriber. Note that this is a Python file and as you can see, it is receiving the Hello World messages. Now let's go back and shut down our publisher using Ctrl C. And let's look at our subscriber. It's still listening, but since there is no published message, it doesn't receive any messages. You can start the publisher again and then check on the next terminal and see that the messages are now being communicated again. This shows that your ROS2 is working and shows two very powerful concepts of ROS. One, communication, and second, supporting multiple programming languages. We had our publisher in C++ and our subscriber in Python and it still worked very smoothly. Next, we'll learn how to use Webots and ROS2 together. I will add the link here once the video is published. Meanwhile, you can check out the video on how to install Webots and get started. If you have any questions or doubts, use the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.